give it up for our Junkanoo dancers. Junkanoo is actually something that I grew up with in Jamaica, and that is actually Kingston, Jamaica, where I was born and raised. And what Junkanoo really is a celebration. It's done every Christmas, and pretty much like how you have your Christmas, you know, parade here, well, people dress up and they dance in the streets and other people join them. So we celebrate, you know, Christmas, the end of the year, and the coming of the new year, and that's how we've always done it. This is done in several different islands, and I guess it's just an island thing. There's some islands that still do it, you know, like Jamaica and Bahamas, but some don't because they now have carnival instead, and carnival's more sophisticated, you know. But usually the costume is made, and it's usually supposed to be scary, and they chase the kids around. It's actually pretty fun. So we just had Junkanoo, right? So y'all didn't miss it. Look at that. And it's just fun to be silly from time to time. All right. Oops. What'd I do? I hit it too fast. Coming up here at Oak Brook. Now I'm sweating. My workout for the day. Tuesday, December 31st, Worldwide Peace Vigil at 7 a.m. This is something that's happening all over the world. Sunday, January 5th at 8:30 a.m. First Sunday breakfast at Daryl's Doggone Good Diner. Doggone good. And Oak Brook people get to meet there and have fun and celebrate before coming for the meditation and the celebration. And Sunday, January 5th, Leadership Council meeting right after the celebration. And that's actually something you are all invited to attend. If you're ever wondering, you know, how does it work here at Oak Brook, then this is how it works. And you can get a chance to have your voice heard. These are all members of Oak Brook that come together and give 3 years of their time as part of the board. And then we have World of Wonder. Do we have another video for that? No. Well, this is a 2014 Spiritual Living Convention, February 16th to the 21st. And if you want to get some more information, let us know. This is something that's usually in a Sylmar, right? Just different places. Well, this time it's going to be here in our own backyard, so we should definitely try to attend. Okay. And now, do you want to speak to the youth? The Spiritual Living Cruise, it's coming out April 6th to the 12th, and the initial deposit was due December 1st, but that was just to hold the position.
I just wanted to say that we had thought that December 1st would end that $250, but it goes into January. So those of you who want to put your deposit down by mid-January, you will also have $250 guaranteed for your deposit.
Oh, how wonderful. Yeah, that's definitely good news because I thought we missed the really good price. So apparently we have not missed the really good price. And this is going to be amazing, you guys. The Holmes Institute ministerial students are also going to be having classes on this cruise. And we will be invited to sit in on some of those classes. And I'm really looking forward to that. Shanna?
There we go. Okay, so we got a couple of things that I have been put in charge of. We did get a few people to sign up to help with the youth. We still need some more. I would like to have about 10 or 12 people total, but I'll take 8. I've already got 2 definites. I would really like at least 2 more before next week, so that we go into January knowing who's going to watch the kids each Sunday, as the majority of the children will be out here through the month of January to get the basics of science of mind, which we all look forward to in January, kind of get back to what we're really built on. So the older kids are going to be out here, and I need someone to assist in watching the younger children so that they have lots of activities to do and they get focused back there and we can really get down to business out here. Also, there's a really cool project called Project Thank You that will be completed by Brunch Sunday. Anyone that does any volunteering, anyone throughout, it doesn't even just have to be recent, anything you have done within the last year to help here at Oak Brook that people may not know about or that you know, maybe everyone hears about every now and then, but no one really understands everything each other does. And this is our chance to thank each other. It's our chance for the leadership of the church to thank the congregation. So if you would see me, I'm getting a list of what everybody does, and it's going to be a really neat treat. I have fun putting slideshows together, and y'all have no idea what I have in store. So come see me after church.
All right. And now we have the Science of Mind reading by Mr. Brandon Allen.
Good morning. This is not today's reading. It's actually from January. It's titled The Enjoyment of Joy. Some of our great thinkers, including Ernest Holmes, Joseph Campbell, and Thomas Troward, tell us that the great spiritual themes of our lives, such as faith and beauty, are within. We do not have to make tracks to attain them, but we do have to expect to experience them. Same with joy, as far as I'm concerned. Joy is inherent in our thoughts and feelings as well as in our very genes. This is why it can surface in us for no reason at all. Funerals and memorials are some of the saddest events we can experience. Still, I have never been involved in one where some form of joy did not come up. Sometimes in a brief smile, a remembered episode, or even full-on laughter. There it was, just as natural as it can be. I make the distinction between happiness and joy because I think happiness is an event-based thing. When things go as we would like, we are happy. Joy needs none of this because it is simply what it is, and it is a part of our spiritual inheritance. Many times, it is necessary to simply notice what is going on inside. We always know when we are upset. So strong are those feelings. What we may not be noting are the quiet essences that are enfolded in joy, maybe just through a soft word. Something came and something went, and we're still smiling. It sounds like work, joy at work. And the affirmation? I live in oneness. I live in the glow of oneness. Joy moves inside of me every chance it gets. It makes itself known, and so it is. Thank you.
Thank you, Brandon. Welcome to Oak Brook Center for Spiritual Living on the last Sunday of 2013 and the fifth day of Christmas. So, Merry fifth day of Christmas, if I didn't already say that to you this morning. I did want to, Shanna, I would like to append the thing about requesting volunteers. How often will they need to actually be with the kids and not be in church?
The more I get, the less often they have to be back there.
Okay.
If I can get, that's the reason I'm looking for 8 to 12 people. If I can get 8 people, you're back here once every 2 months.
Yes, okay. With the kids once every 2 months and the rest of the time here with us. Okay, let's stand for Colors of Praise.
Look around at the rainbow of people who come to praise. Single mother dressed in red stands next to a World War vet. And up in the front there are children, brown, black, and white. Oh, the candle glows and the spirit flows. The word's been brought to life. We come together today. Shout to the walk a different path. Walk to find the love that loves her. Here to paint a picture of gladness and joy in God. Some in t-shirts, some wear tight chains. Many who have changed their lives. From the streets we have come to make this place our very home. All the candles. Evermore, God flows like a rainbow. Our hearts know as the joy grows. We all show the colors of godliness. Oh, the candle glows and the spirit glows. The word's been brought to
thank you.
going to lead us in our affirmation today, so be ready. I celebrate the happiness that life is always giving. I am grateful for the good that has been mine in 2013, and I choose to make every day in 2014 a holiday, a day to celebrate, and so it is. And then from what we believe, yes, let's applaud that. Yes, that's good affirmation. We'll get to say it again later. We believe in the incarnation of the Spirit in everyone, and that all people are incarnations of the one Spirit. Reverend Vicki, you want to lead us in the Oak Brook affirmation? Okay. Come on down.
All right.
Need a mic. Just grab a mic.
Good morning.
Good morning.
And now we'll have our Oak Brook affirmation, and you already know, and you already do it, with enthusiasm. I am thankful for Oak Brook, for the teaching of the science of mind as in every way of life at every age, and for the abundance it brings into my life, my center, and my world. I am grateful for our ever-growing spiritual community of love, freedom, and acceptance. I celebrate with a thankful heart our beautiful new spacious center as we welcome our divine unfoldment through gifts of music, encouragement of our youth, and all life-enhancing activities. Oak Brook's vision supports us all in experiencing full and realized lives of spirit and expression. God's love empowers. Fantastic. And now, let's just take a deep breath and know that we are here in this holy space that encourages us and the service that loves us, and God that loves us is so evident in each person here. Not just those participating in the service, but also all of you who are here who have been called with a divine calling to come today. This was the day to come. And so we greet our visitors and we greet each other knowing that we are in our right place and we are surrounded by so much beauty, and we know that God definitely loves us. And so that love continues as the service goes on. And for we know that Reverend Peggy has prepared a talk for us which will help us in some certain special way. And so I give thanks for all of this, and so it is.
Bottom of my heart.
Emmanuel, 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 wonderful counselor, Lord of life, Lord of all, he is the Prince of Peace, mighty God, Holy One, Emmanuel, 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 wonderful counselor, Lord of life, Lord of all, he is the Prince of Peace, mighty God, Holy One.
Our Joyful Noise and Youth gave us that wonderful music program last week for our candlelight service, and then they stayed and practiced so that they would be ready for this morning. Let's give them another hand. Hardworking team, hardworking group. You know, this is a wonderful time of year, and if we don't remember to celebrate Christmas all 12 days, we're missing out. How many of us thought it was over Wednesday night? Nobody in this room. It isn't over till we say it's over. And that's one of the great good things about our teaching of the science of mind, is that we get to create the life that we choose, even when it comes to holidays. So, Junkanoo, how many of that was new to you this year? Never heard of Junkanoo before. And to have an authentic Junkanoo right in front of us from Jamaica, we're very blessed. But here we've had Christmas, and I affirm that all of your Christmases were amazing and wonderful, and all were of your own choosing. Even Christmas trees don't have to look the same. You know, we have this wonderful big Christmas tree, and a lot of you helped to decorate it at the beginning of the month. At home, I have a Christmas tree that's only about this tall, and it sits on a table. And that's what I choose to have there. But you know, you don't even have to make Christmas trees look like Christmas trees. So I brought some examples of some things that may not look like a Christmas tree until you make it into a Christmas tree. Here's one. In a library, it's made out of books with Christmas balls and lights on it. Isn't that neat? So how appropriate it is for a library to make a Christmas tree out of books. Or if you like to drink beer, you could collect them all year long and have a Christmas tree made out of empty beer bottles with lights around that. And I'm sure that is really pretty at night. The picture that I had was during the day. Or you could have a Christmas tree made out of driftwood. Or you could even wear your Christmas tree. So we are open to all the possibilities for Christmas in our lives. And let the Christmas tree examples here just be samples of what it is we might like to do with our Christmas next year, or what we want to do now. I've done some of my decorating. Since my mom was visiting, I didn't finish decorating my apartment. And I'm going to go do that this afternoon. I hadn't finished it because it just didn't work out with her being here, but I want to have it there. And there's still 7 more days of Christmas, right? So we're not limited at all. 2 days ago, and I did not know this till I was looking for what things to celebrate this time of year, His Holiness Paramahansa Nityananda celebrated his 37th birthday. He is in India and head of the largest Hindu group there. In 100 countries, 100 million people are in their congregation, and he is the most watched spiritual leader on YouTube. So happy birthday, His Holiness Paramahansa Nityananda. They call it Avatar Day. Mm. Now here is Junkanoo in the Bahamas. When we first got started and we had it live and also on video, Adonna was telling us how it is in Jamaica. Here it is in the Bahamas. So if you missed it, you still have a few days to fly over to the Bahamas or get a quick cruise, because their parades are at 1 in the morning on the 26th and 1 in the morning on New Year's Day. So if you want to get over there, you haven't missed it, there it is for you. And it lasts all this week. So let's go back to Christmas. And I invite us to think about the Christmas story. And I'm going to read a little bit from the book of Luke. And it came to pass as the angels were gone away from them. This is the shepherds. The shepherds said to one another, "Let us go even into Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying that was said to them concerning the child. And all they that heard of it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Now, all of us have new Christmas memories this week. And when the 25th of December was over, did you find yourself in a place like I did, where I just kind of was reviewing the celebration? Just kind of reviewing the day. Perhaps I was pondering in my heart what the Christmas celebration meant to me this year. And for us to think about, what does that mean? Here's Mary, the mother of Jesus. She knew that she was going to give birth, obviously. That was not a surprise to her. But when she did give birth, for it to be welcomed by people and people talking about it may have been something she did not expect. What are we pondering this Christmas season regarding our Christmas, regarding what it is that we created? You know, last week, so many of you, as we spoke about Christmas spirit especially, got in the line to light the Christmas spirit candles. Did you notice that? That was the most popular of all of them, was Christmas spirit. And more than any other one of our candles were Christmas spirit lives here, hearts. So that's an interesting thing, you know, as we make our choice to live in that spirit of Christmas and to allow ourselves to celebrate in lots of ways all the time. Ernest Holmes tells us life will become one grand song when we realize that since God is for us, none can be against us. Since God is for us, none can be against us. If God's everywhere present, if God is all there is, then who is there that could be against us? What power could there possibly be in the universe that could detract from the joy that we want to be experiencing as we celebrate, for example? We shall cease merely to exist. We shall live. So as 2013 is coming to a close, and 2014 is waiting in the wings for us, we have a chance to look at our lives. And Cindy, this morning in meditation, did a wonderful job of inviting us to see how we'd grown in 2013 and spent time in the silence, contemplating that, pondering in our heart what 2013 has brought for us, and then setting our intentions for 2014. What is joy? Here we're talking about celebrations, Junkanoo, or the birthday of a guru that many people put as a high avatar, the birth of Jesus. What exactly is joy? You know, Ernest Holmes tells us he thinks joy is the anticipation of good. Does that definition work for you? Joy is the anticipation of good. And thank you so much, Brandon, for finding that. We couldn't find Science of Mind for this month on purpose because you were to find that one for this month coming up and speak about joy. And did you know I was going to talk about joy?
A little bit.
A little bit. Okay.
Okay,
that's a holiday. See, you're already ready for that. This idea of how do we create joy in our lives. I'd like to read from this thing called Life by Ernest Holmes. Let us learn to live by inspiration. That means we should let the spiritual depths of our being flow through our conversation and into our acts. Living by inspiration does not mean living chaotically. Our whole purpose is to make the intellect an instrument for the spirit. This is exactly what the artist does. We must all become artists in living. To live by inspiration means to sense the divine touch in everything, to enter into the spirit of things, to enter into the joy of living. Let's all become artists of living, sensing the divine touch in everything, to enter into the joy of living. Here's another quote. Joy is a magnet. It draws more joy to it. As Donna and Iman and Lori were dancing out here, we didn't know what they were doing yet, but we were already filled with joy, weren't we? Before Donna's explanation of Junkanoo, and we saw that on the screen, we know they were happy about something. And so if we were to consider the history of Junkanoo, you know, that's one of the real nebulous things about the history of it. It's not really a known thing, except from that it came from Africa and the slaves, especially in the islands, and the coastal regions of this country celebrated it. Now, I don't know where it's being celebrated, probably somewhere in Florida today and this week, but the islands really held on to it. And it was kind of combined with the idea of the British then in Jamaica, and those that were slaves were freed on that day to go visit relatives that might be on a different plantation. And I've been watching Downton Abbey, and at the week after Christmas, they have what they call the servants' ball. And they kind of turn the tables on who's the servants and who are the lords there, and there's something in this time of year, and it goes all the way back to the celebration of Janus in the Roman years, where the slaves became for a day the lords, and those that were the lords became the slaves. So there's something all tied in that together, and we don't quite understand it, but it does open the way, doesn't it, for us to have a larger vision of our life. You know, if we're not caught up in a certain scenario, perhaps being free one day of the year encouraged the Jamaican slaves to rebel. Maybe having a feeling of what it felt like to be free one day encouraged them to want to feel free every day. And for us to see that in our own lives, we come to Christmas, that's the day of joy, we speak of peace on earth, but how do we carry that through the year other than to decide, to make that decision that joy is going to draw more joy into our lives every day of the year and not just make it during the Christmas season, right? This is a quote from Edwin Gaines, by the way. And we get that feeling sense. Babies know how to feel joyful, don't they? They don't just smile with their face. They laugh with their whole body, don't they? When they're really happy, and little ones do that too as they're growing up. But we sometimes forget what that is like, that joy that reaches for that hug, that joy, except when you're at Oak Brook and you reach out to hug one another and know that that will be received well, right? In Philippians, near the end of the fourth chapter, near the end of the book of Philippians, which was, of course, Paul's letter to the people that lived in Philippi, he said, "Rejoice in our Lord always. I will say again, rejoice." And so if we were to put that in New Thought terms, he's definitely a New Thought dolphin, I'm sure. The joyful thing about going across the water with the tail, right? Here's a quote from one of the founders of Divine Science. She does this quote, "Rejoice in our Lord always, and I will say again, rejoice." We rejoice in the sunshine, we rejoice in the rain. And she says the reason that we do that is because in everything we give thanks and acknowledge the omnipresence. We give thanks because God is in and through and as everything. And, of course, Oprah gives us her wisdom on the same subject. The more you praise and celebrate your life, the more there is in life to celebrate. How many of you this morning feel that you're up-leveling your Christmas celebration from what it has been in the past? You're actually consciously making a choice to enjoy Christmas more, for it to not be down at the end of the 25th, but go on and on and on. How many of you celebrate your birthday over more than one day? This is really catching on, where people are celebrating the whole month of their birthday. They're not limiting their birthday celebration to just one day. We're talking about celebrating life, and we're finding every particular excuse we can think of to make life joyful. And Oprah's encouraging us to do that. The more you praise and celebrate your life, the more there is in life to celebrate. And the sun never sets on that, does it? The sun never sets on celebrations of life. Because we know that tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow will maybe not be Junkanoo, but there'll be a celebration probably going on somewhere in the world that's an organized one, and we can join into that conscious awareness, and we can just make our own choices. And it doesn't mean we're trying to capture the day, does it? We're not trying to hold the moment, because life is made of an eternity of ever-present moments, but the light can shine through us. So here we are at the end of the year, celebrating endings because they precede new beginnings. And for us to take a look at 2013, and of course the invitation is that we take only the good with us into 2014. If something has been especially troublesome for us in 2013, we get to leave it behind. And we get to bring forward just the good, the lessons that we've learned, and the love that we have and share, and all the good that there is. This is that joy, this joy of anticipation. And there is some wisdom here, you know, with Charlie Brown saying, "Goodbye always makes my throat hurt." There may be something about 2013 that you don't want to leave behind. But here's another poem as Charlie Brown is going to sleep. Day is over, night has come, today is gone, what's done is done. Embrace your dreams through the night. Tomorrow comes with a whole new light. And I invite us to apply this to the year. The year is over in a few days, and the night has come of that year. But today is gone. What's done is done. Embrace your dreams through the night. The new year comes with a whole new light. So on January 8th, We usually do this on the first Wednesday of the new year, but since it's a holiday, we will be doing it on the 8th. We have our bowl burning and intention setting. It'll be in a circle in this room, or rows of circles, facing the fireplace. We'll have a nice fire in the fireplace, with the intention that we let go of all that we want to leave in the past. We write it down, and we throw it into the fire. Any concepts that we no longer want to have in our life, any happenings that we don't want to have as a burden anymore in our life, and you can have any numbers of pieces of paper to write these things on. And then we throw them into the fire. No one needs to know what we've written, but it's fun to watch it burn up and really get the sense that it's behind us, that we don't have to carry it forward into 2014. And then we have a meditation and we get centered, because as we set our intentions for 2014, we want those to come from a deep place of awareness, don't we? We don't want it to just be a surface thing of, I want this and this and this and this in 2014. We want to let that wisdom self within us be the one that's guiding us as we make our choices for 2014. And then we write those down. And then we take those home with us, with the idea that we look at them from time to time. And over and over and over again, people have told me how the things that they wrote down at that service on the first Wednesday of the year come into manifestation well before the next year has come and gone. And for us to see the power in that, and see the power that as we come together in that, we lift one another up. Eleanor Roosevelt said, "Happiness is not a goal. It's a byproduct of a life well lived." So our goal is not just to be joyful, but our goal is to live that well lived life, which includes expressing joy which includes expressing love, which includes all the good that life has to bring for us. So let's look forward to 2014. Next Sunday, Cindy's going to be bringing in the new year in our first Sunday service. I won't be here, but I'll be eager to hear it or see it. So be here next Sunday and support Cindy as this new year is beginning, and she's inviting some great things from us. And for us to see every day as a holiday. The definition, that very first definition of holiday means holy day. And that holy day is, of course, a day where the divine is present, right? And is there any day that the divine is not present? We may forget that the divine is there, but as soon as we remember it, we've turned that regular day into a holiday. So let's do our affirmation together. And you did it so well before and applauded it. Let's do that now, shall we? I celebrate the happiness that life is always giving. I am grateful for all the good that has been mine in 2013. And I choose to make every day in 2014 a holiday, a day to celebrate life. And so it is. Let's give ourselves applause for that, because we recognize the truth of that, don't we? We recognize that as we set that intention. So let's turn within for a moment, shall we? Let's give thanks for all the good that's come to us in this year. Let's give thanks for one another here at Oak Brook, and that this center exists so that we can be encouraged and lifted and get those hugs and encouragements from one another. Let's give thanks knowing that the universe is a safe place, because in every present moment, in every place where we find ourselves, the wisdom and the infinite power and love of the divine is right there, supporting us, blessing us, encouraging us. Let us give thanks for the clean slate that 2014 presents to us. Let's give thanks for our ability to set intentions and know that we didn't miss Junkanoo. We didn't miss Christmas. We haven't missed anything. All that is good is forever ours. And we can choose to celebrate it in any present moment that we choose. I give thanks that this is so. And so it is.
and I thank you.
Thank you, Joyful Noise. Expanded version of Joyful Noise with our young people. Let's give them another hand, shall we? Now it's time for sharing our abundance and celebrating that. It's so easy to give this time of year, isn't it? And as we know that giving and receiving are really the same thing, because we are all one, it's especially a time for celebration here at Oak Brook. So as we hold our gift in our hand, and I'm right now holding a gift from my sister and her husband that she gave me for Oak Brook this year on Christmas Day. She said they just felt to, and they never have been here to church, but they just felt to give a gift to Oak Brook this year. Let's hold our gifts to our heart and share affirmation in unison together. How good it is to know that I am the place where the abundance of the universe flows. And as the abundance flows through me, it is with a grateful heart that I give. I know that as I give, so much more is given back to me. Gratefully and joyfully, I give of my time, my talents, my gifts, and my heart. And so it is. And those of you with prayer requests, hold them up so that Ron will find you with our poinsettia decorated prayer chest. As we turn within to that centered place of all abundance, let us give thanks. Let us give thanks for our connection with the infinite through our giving. Let us give thanks knowing that as we give, it is always multiplied tenfold and more, that our lives are blessed because of our willingness to be that blessing. Let us give thanks that we know that the gifts and tithes today are helping to make Oak Brook Center for Spiritual Living thrive and be possible for tomorrow. That this center exists because of the divine idea that it is, because of the givingness that has unfolded out throughout the years, and because of the givingness now. I give thanks that this is so. And I give thanks for our prayer requests. I know in my heart that outstanding unfoldment that's already taking place because these prayer requests have been written and put in our prayer chest. The answer to each and every request already exists in divine mind, that field of all possibilities, which is that all good, which invites our joy. I give thanks for our prayer ministry team that are already praying about these requests right now and will be this upcoming week in confidence. I give thanks for their knowingness of answered prayer, of divine manifestation, of great good flowing in our lives. I give thanks that it's already done, and so it is. And now, in preparation for Cindy giving us our spiritual mind treatment, our affirmative prayer, let's just remain seated. There's something on the video for us.
You are a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. You have a right.
Go placidly amid the noise and haste, and remember what peace there may be in silence. As far as possible without surrender, be on good terms with all persons. Speak your truth quietly and clearly, and listen to others, even the dull and ignorant. They too have their story. Avoid loud and aggressive persons. They are vexations to the spirit. If you compare yourself with others, you may become vain and bitter. For always there will be greater and lesser persons than yourself.
You are a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. You have a right to be here, and whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding.
Enjoy your achievements as well as your plans. Keep interested in your own career. However humble, it is a real possession in the changing fortunes of time. Exercise caution in your business affairs, for the world is full of trickery. But let this not blind you to what virtue there is. Many persons strive for high ideals, and everywhere life is full of heroism. Be yourself. Especially do not feign affection. Neither be cynical about love. For in the face of all aridity and disenchantment, it is as perennial as the grass. Take kindly the counsel of the years, gracefully surrendering the things of youth. Nurture strength of spirit to shield you in sudden misfortune. But do not distress yourself with imaginings. Many fears are born of fatigue and loneliness. Beyond a wholesome discipline, be gentle with yourself.
You are a child
of the universe. No less than the trees and the stars. You have a right to be here. And whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should. Therefore, be at peace with God, whatever you conceive Him to be, and whatever your labors and aspirations in the noisy confusion of life, keep peace with your soul. With all its sham, drudgery, and broken dreams, it is still a beautiful world. Be careful. Strive to be happy.
You are a child of the universe.
Child of the universe, no less than the tree. Now, if you would just take this moment to turn within, maybe close your eyes if you feel so moved. And just take a deep breath and relax and feel yourself in that secret place of the Most High. That place where we feel ourselves at one with the presence that runs in and around and through all things. That field of infinite possibility from which all things are created. I know the spirit of Christmas lives in each and every one here, and I affirm that each one lives in a spirit of joy, anticipating and realizing more and more good in their lives in the days and weeks to come. I affirm that as each one goes forward this week, they easily release that which no longer serves them, and that in releasing these burdens, they are open to all of the good that life has to offer, and feel that life as a celebration, as holy days that make for a life well lived. And I affirm that as each one goes forward into his or her respective experience, that all needs are met with grace and ease, and that each one is in the flow of God's infinite abundance. I know that each one is safe and secure, surrounded by the power and presence of the divine. And so I give thanks for all these children of the universe, for all these beautiful lights, for knowing that as they shine their light, the path is illumined for so many others. I release these words with joyous expectation and excitement for knowing that it is already done. And so it is.
Thank you. Thank you, Cindy, for that wonderful treatment. And let's stand for I'm Stepping Out.
I'm stepping out into a world of possibility. I'm stepping out into a whole new way to live. There's so much waiting for me. The path is clear before me. I've got so much that I have yet to give. I'm stepping out and I'm committing to integrity. I'm stepping out, releasing every fear and doubt. The road just keeps on turning. At every turn I'm learning. I'm learning what this life is all about. Stepping out into a world of possibility. I'm stepping out into a whole new way to live. There's so much waiting for me. The path is clear before me. I've got so much that I have yet to give. I'm stepping out and I'm committing to integrity. I'm stepping out, releasing every fear and doubt. The road just keeps on turning, and every turn I'm learning what this life is all about.
Form our circle for the peace song. How appropriate, the last Sunday of the year we should sing the peace song.
And do join us at 7 in the morning. Reverend Vicki will be leading us on the 31st for the peace vigil that takes place around the world at that same moment everywhere. And just be glad that you don't live in California because they meet at 4 in the morning. Want to come down, Vicki? The little one's coming. Here we go. Okay. Thank you, Sender.